When I started buying camera bags, I thought I needed what most companies were offering. Millions of pockets, ballistic fabrics, and Velcro padding that could be arranged in more configurations than an MC Escher drawing. But what I realized over time is that I didn't need a million pockets. I needed a few, and they needed to fit the objects that I carried. I didn't want ballistic fabrics. I'm not a SWAT team. I'm a photographer. And really, most of the things that I carry around are going on clothes like I'm wearing right now. So if they're black and Cordura and Kevlar and they're mistaken for a bulletproof vest, not only do they not really fit my lifestyle, but they also just don't fit conceptually with what I feel like I really identify with. And in terms of padding, and I know this goes against everything that the camera industry will tell you, I need padding when I travel on an airplane. When I'm walking around in the street, I don't need it. Most of the time, the camera's in my hand. Inside of the small bag, one of the changes that I made was that there are two internal pockets which I would store either a little notebook in or a single lens. And sometimes it was a little frustrating because the pockets were asymmetrical. One was smaller than the other. So one could only fit the notebook and one could only fit the lens. What I did was expand them a little bit because they weren't far off. I just wanted there to be enough space to put lenses in both sides if it's something I wanted. This way I didn't have to think about which slot got the lens and which slot didn't. In making a bag, I wanted to offer a second size that was going to do two things. It was going to allow for SLR shooters to have an alternative to a lot of the other bags that we've already seen. Something that could carry two of their bodies. Yeah, this isn't the biggest bag. You're not going to be able to put five lenses and two bodies in here. But really, if you just need a camera body and an extra lens or two bodies with two dedicated lenses on them, they're going to fit well in something that's this size. I've designed it so that inside we have a button-out panel that divides the two sections. It's completely removable so that you can have the whole open section. If whatever inserts you use don't exactly configure to the way that you'd like it, or if you'd like to button it up and use half of it for the way that I do it, I have my camera gear on one half and I have headphones and things, DVDs and notebooks on the other half, especially when I'm flying. And to not interfere with this, there's a back panel that allows you to put a laptop or an iPad, so that can be totally separate and you can still have a dividing section in between. With so many products on the market, it's kind of impossible to say what's the best. You know, this is the best camera bag or this is the best camera. None of it really exists. It's what's the best for you and for your needs. And for a select group of photographers who have really specific needs, travel I see as being a big part of it. Lightweight, usability, something that's gonna age really well, and something that's gonna be a no-fuss solution that isn't gonna really stand out in the crowd. That's really who I designed these bags for. I'm really happy to bring these to everybody, and I look forward to hearing from you, all right? We'll see you on the road somewhere. Take care.